Hello, I was going to show y'all what Lincoln Brewster's patches were. I found on the internet or on YouTube that nobody really posted. You have to go to the website and download it and all that. Or you could just use this video. I'm fixing to show you exactly what he has going on. I've noticed that the main source of his sound has a lot to do with the EQ setting that he uses, because you can put that EQ setting, I'm going to show you here in a minute, on pretty much any amp, and it's going to sound really good if you're using a Strat. I don't know if it's like boosting the mids or what's actually going on. It might not sound as good on like a Les Paul or something with humbuckers in it, but on single coils it really sounds good. Let me show you. Alright, that's the amp he's using right there. And there's his settings. This is his boost distortion, and I use this a lot. It's real clear. It adds a little bit of extra grit or a little bit of extra gain to what you got going on. Right now it's off, but that's just exactly how I downloaded the patch on here. And square chorus, digital delay, kind of almost got that slap back at 319 milliseconds. He has reverb off, which is odd. But that reverb sounds pretty good. I normally go with the deluxe reverb. To me, it's one of the better sound ones. Noise gate. He's got that one off right now. But normally on the other patches, he has this one running. And there's your compressor settings. Now here's the important part right here. I'll let y'all get a good look at that, because that right there, if you dial that in on your processor and then take that and push the on and off button over here, right here, and just try it with and without while you're playing in a little lick or something, and you'll hear a huge difference. It really sounds really good. And anyway, get your wah there. Volume, effects loop, and that's it for that one. Alright, well, let's back out of, because this is a dual tone. We'll go down to the next tone and see if there's any difference. Alright. Yep. There's that amp. Silver 12, 1967. There's his amp settings. Same kind of distortion thing going on. Square chorus, digital delay, dark call, reverb, noise gate, compressor, and you notice that, let me go back, the noise gate was off on the other one. Let's say the compressor, it was running on the other one, and the equalizer, I've tried it both ways. If you run two equalizers in a 2 amp setup on this thing, it tends to be not as rich sounding as you'd like it to be. So normally what I do is just run the second amp and leave it dry. You can put some extra delay or reverb or something in there, but I normally just leave it dry. Maybe put like a tube screamer or something on there, but that's it. And there's the wah setting, volume pedal, and all that. Okay. Clip back out of there. Alright, that's his channel 18 plexi lead. on the Line 6 X3 Live.